Goalkeeping is one of the most important parts of creating a successful team. The increased speed of the game and the improved skills of the players create new challenges for goalkeeping. The purpose of this video is to give ideas on how to develop goalkeeping and to give tools for improved goalkeeper coaching.
My name is Jarno Ihme. I play for Peliveljet and men's national team. 12 years. I was in the goal from the very start and liked it immediately, so decided to stay between the bars.
The basic goalkeeping position is the foundation of successful goalkeeping. The proper basic goalkeeping position enables fast hand and leg movements while making saves. The height of the hands is a bit below the shoulder line and in front of the body. Elbows can be used to stop the shots targeted towards the armpits. The upper body is leaning forward slightly and the legs are free to move towards both sides. The simultaneous movement of the hands and legs is an important basic saving skill. The symmetric control of the body is required for good goalkeeping. In order to automatize the basic saving movements, you need to do repetitions of certain simple moves that are common in normal game play. Besides these basic movements, it is also important to improve the speed of the hands, arms, and legs. In order to develop catching skills, a lot of catching repetition is needed. This increases quick response of the nervous system and improves overall catching skills. One drill for training this is to try catching the ball with only your left hand or your right hand, and with both hands simultaneously. Follow the goalkeeper's moving technique on the video. Take notice of how the goalkeeper is using his legs and his hip flexibility. Notice that his hands are ready to make saves all the time. A goalkeeper must be able to move backwards quickly. The movement should happen by using his legs, so that his hands are free to make saves at all times. Different techniques are used in different game situations. On the video, you can see the goalkeeper using the small step technique in a game situation. With this technique, the sideways movement is slow but rational in this particular game situation. Moving side to side with the sliding step technique is fast. On the video, you can see an exercise which is good for practicing the sliding step technique. Notice the good positioning of the goalkeeper. Very quick sideways movements are needed in fast game situations. Practice all different saving techniques in game situations as much as you can. Always try to stay up in the knee position. Diving to the side should be avoided until the last moment.
When saving basic shots, I try to first move towards the player, keeping the ball in my sight all the time, and then make the save in the basic saving posture.
The goalkeeper should try to block the passing lanes and be ready to stop the passes that come near or in front of the goal. Stopping a pass is done with either the hands or the legs. Notice the rhythm of the exercise. The exercise is done according to the conditions of the goalkeeper. the goalkeeper should concentrate on each performance. Take notice of the goalkeeper's positioning in the different dimensions, both horizontally and vertically. Here you can see an exercise for developing goalkeeper's movement in a side triangle passing drill. The goalkeeper should notice the positioning of the two players and be ready to move towards the shot by following the pass. If the goalkeeper overcommits towards the shooter, the player can make an additional pass and the goalkeeper must then react quickly to the new situation.
If the shot comes after a pass from the end of the rink, I try to move enough towards the shot and try to cover as much of the shooting sector as possible. I try to maintain the basic saving position and keep my eyes on the ball at all times.
Shots made after diagonal passes from different distances require a fast evaluation of the situation. Goalkeepers must choose the correct saving technique for each situation. Take notice of how the goalkeeper is playing up in the knee position. In this exercise, the sideways movement of the goalkeeper must be extremely fast. Develop your moving technique in the knee position faster by doing repeated practices. Here you can see an exercise for the goalkeeper's movement in a back triangle passing drill. This is a basic exercise for practicing playing short-handed. The goalkeeper's aim is to stay on top of the situation by moving quickly with forward, backward, and sideways moving techniques.
In a diagonal pass situation, I try to maintain my eyes on the ball and move towards the shooter with a sliding kick.
Goalkeepers' sideways and forward-backward movements are in relation to the speed of the player. The closer to the goal the player is, the faster the goalkeeper must move.
When the player breaks in, shooting a long wrist shot, I try to move sideways with the small step technique.
This is a good exercise for goalkeepers learning to read the game. The goalkeeper must quickly evaluate the speed and direction of the pass. Goalkeepers should play the situation actively. When the ball is behind the goal, goalkeepers should follow how the situation develops. At the same time, the goalkeeper should be aware of the players in front of the goal in case the ball is passed to them. Intercepting the pass can be done with both hands or legs, depending on the situation. Notice that the goalkeeper needs to be constantly prepared to move from post to post sideways. If the ball is passed from behind the goal to the player in front of the goal, the goalkeeper must move quickly towards the shot in the passing direction.